Hello students, today let us discuss the topic Selective Assembly Approach. So, as the name indicates, Selective Assembly Approach. So, here we can say that we are selecting the components for making the assembly. From the name, we can say we are selecting the components to make the assembly. So, if we go into the detail, we will know what selective assembly approach is actually. So, this approach is a very cost-effective approach for reducing overall variation and improving the quality of an assembled product. So, this is a cost-effective approach for reducing overall variation and improving the quality of an assembled product. So, this selective assembly focuses on the fit between the mating parts rather than the absolute dimension of each component. So, it will focus on the fit between the components and not the absolute dimension of the component. So, what is actually done in this selective assembly approach? In this approach, the mating components are measured, they are sorted by dimension, and they are binned into groups. So, first we will measure the component, we will sort them based on their dimensions, and then we will bin it or we will keep it in different groups before the assembly process. Then, when the assembly is done, the final product of the assembly is done by selecting the components from the appropriate bins. In this way, we will achieve optimal assembly dimensions. So, this technique is most suitable where close fit of two component assemblies are required. So, this technique will help for protection against non-conforming assemblies and reduce machining cost since close tolerance can be maintained. So, if we go into the example for this selective assembly, if some parts to be assembled are manufactured with a tolerance of 0.01 mm, then an automatic gauge can separate them into 10 different groups of 0.001 mm limit of selective assembly of the individual part. So, the parts with the tolerance of 0.01 mm are obtained, and both the conditions of high quality and low cost can be achieved by this selective assembly technique. So, for example, so some parts are manufactured with a tolerance of 0.01 mm. Then what happens? An automatic gauge can separate them in 10 different groups, 0.001 mm limit of selective assembly of the individual parts. So, by this, the parts with the tolerance of 0.001 mm are obtained, and so the conditions of both low cost and high quality can be achieved. So, this type of assembly is often used in aircraft, automobile, or other industries where tolerances are very narrow and are not possible to be manufactured by sophisticated machines at reasonable cost. So, it is selective assembly is often used in aircraft, automobiles, and industries where the tolerances are very narrow. So, by this we can say that this selective assembly is a very useful approach. So, what are the advantages of selective assembly? So, the first one, so this is a very fair, clear, and low cost method. So, this will increase the efficiency of the process. It gives high quality in the assembly. It reduces cost of manufacturing. It will reduce the machining cost. So this is all about selective assembly.